So I was hoping today to see that most of you already have a pending deposit in your bank accounts for your $1,400 third stimulus checks. But unfortunately, that isn't the case. There are so many of you that still do not see anything pending in your accounts at all. So in this video, I'll be going over which banks have already begun processing third stimulus payments for its cardholders. I will also discuss when your $1,400 will actually be available to you and why Direct Express cardholders may be the last to receive their stimulus money. Thank you so much for being here. Please subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends and family so we can help as many people as we can finally get their third stimulus check. Also, the winner of this week's $50 Amazon gift card giveaway is Gray Cloudy Day. Congratulations! But next Friday, I will be giving away another $50 Amazon gift card to enter the giveaway. All you'll need to do is subscribe to my channel, like this video, and then comment below. I am so glad for all of you that are finally seeing a pending deposit in your accounts. This is so amazing. But if you are still waiting for your third stimulus check, please leave a comment in the section below to let others know that you are not alone in this. It is really frustrating to know that many of you still do not have a pending deposit in your accounts yet. There may be an issue with Direct Express. I notice that those of you who do not see a pending deposit are Direct Express cardholders. I do not understand or can comprehend why Direct Express is taking forever to process your stimulus payments. There are several other banks that have already processed their customer stimulus checks, but let's go through a list of banks that have already begun processing stimulus money. Netspend, Chime Bank, MetaBank, and Bank of America. Those are four banks that are currently processing stimulus checks for Social Security and other federal program beneficiaries. I do notice that most Netspend customers already see a pending deposit for $1,400 in their bank accounts. Netspend is doing an amazing job with getting those payments processed as quickly as possible. MetaBank customers are also having a great day with their pending deposits. As of right now, I have not seen one Direct Express cardholder that has a pending deposit for their stimulus check. This is just horrible news. I know that many of you that receive SSI, SSDI, RRB, and Survivor benefits use Direct Express. And it makes no sense why you do not see a pending notice yet. If there are any new updates on Direct Express, I will let you know as soon as possible. Credit union customers have also started to see pending deposits in their accounts. The IRS should be available to process 30 million stimulus payments in a day. The IRS processed 90 million payments overnight. If the IRS could do it before, I'm sure they can do it again. I expect to see that the majority of you will have already have a pending deposit in your accounts by the end of this weekend. There are a few Americans that received a little extra stimulus cash in their bank accounts. The Internal Revenue said late Thursday that its third batch of payments includes what it calls the first of many plus up stimulus payments. According to the Internal Revenue Service, these plus up payments will continue on a weekly basis going forward as the agency continues processing tax returns from 2020 and 2019. Yes, some 2019 returns needs to be processed too. Under some circumstances, a person could be eligible for a new or bigger economic impact payment based on the recently processed tax returns. Ongoing supplemental or plus up payments would apply to people who had already received stimulus money earlier in March, but the initial payment was based on a 2019 tax return, not the 2020 return that had been recently filed. Now, even if you see a pending deposit in your accounts today, the IRS does not guarantee that the $1,400 will be available to you tomorrow. Remember, it does take some time for the IRS and the banks to completely process your stimulus money. You should definitely have your money by April 7th. We all know that the IRS Get My Payment tool is not really trustworthy, but for some people receiving Social Security benefits like SSI, SSDI, the IRS and the Treasury announced that the Get My Payment tool will be updated with information for federal beneficiaries the weekend of April 3rd to 4th. Their Internal Revenue Service still does not have any information for VA beneficiaries, which is just so ridiculous. The IRS has not even announced when the Get My Payment tool will be updated for millions of Americans that receive VA benefits. If you are seeing a payment status not available message, please do not worry. I know that many that have received your stimulus checks without the IRS tracking tool even updating. If you receive SSI or SSDI, it is likely that you are eligible to receive a third stimulus check. But right now, all we can do is just patiently wait just for a little bit longer for the IRS and Direct Express to finish processing these payments. Please leave any questions or comments that you have in the comment section below. I'll do my very best to answer those questions.
Never given up and are determined to get the country back on track, as well as their families. But I think it's also a reflection of two things we're doing here. First, the new economic strategy we've launched, one focused on building from the bottom up and the middle out, and one that puts government on the side of working people, and that rewards work, not wealth. When we invest in the American people, it's not just those at the top that make our economy grow. They're the ones that make it grow, ordinary Americans. We saw the economy gain traction in March as the American Rescue Plan moved and got passed, bringing new hope to our country. And we're going to continue to implement that law in the weeks ahead. By April 7th, next week, over 130 million households will have gotten their $1,400 per person rescue check. Funds are on their way to local communities to put educators, healthcare workers, home healthcare aides, police, firefighters, sanitary workers back on the job. They're getting more aid for small businesses. We're also going to hang an open sign again on the door to rehire folks that had to be let go. And in the months ahead, a new child care tax credit will cut taxes and provide help to millions of families with young children. There's nothing, nothing. I know you're tired of hearing me say this, but I mean, there's nothing the American people cannot do if we give them a chance. And the American Rescue Plan does precisely that for hardworking middle-class folks at long last. Down a slow-moving vaccination program and to being the envy of the world. Yesterday, the progress we've worked so hard to achieve can be reversed. On the economic front, the benefits and the impact of the American Rescue Plan are temporary by design. It is a rescue plan. But as we get the economy back on its feet, we need to do the hard work of building back better for good, for not just for a while, but for good. Not just the short term, but for good. That's why I proposed the American Jobs Plan on Wednesday in Pittsburgh. It's an 8-year program that invites and let me put it another way. I've heard from everybody all across the country about the need for infrastructure. How many times have we heard this is infrastructure week the last 4 years? About every second week was infrastructure week, but no infrastructure was built. Well, this is an 8-year program that invests in our roads, our bridges, broadband, airports, ports, and fixing our water systems. It's going to repair our VA hospitals across the country.
This is the end of the video, everyone. I really hope you found this video helpful. Please make sure to enter the $50 Amazon gift card giveaway by subscribing to my channel, liking this video, and then commenting below. Thank you and have a very, very blessed day.